Hey everyone, I am Suresh. In this video, I will show how to create Google Forms and how to change the settings for the Google Forms. For this, first log in with your Gmail account and after that, you go to Google and search for Google Forms. Click on this Google Forms free online service for personal use. Once this Google Form interface is opened, you have different types of this one. These are all Google products like Google Documents, which is used to create MS Word documents, Google Sheets like spreadsheets, which is like Excel, Google Slides, which are used to create the PPTs, and Google Forms. Here you have go to this Google Forms. Click on this go to Google Forms. And we have like this screen will be opened. If you want to create a blank Google Form from scratch, you can click on this one. Or you can use the templates also. These are all predefined templates. And these are the Google Forms that I already created. So for this one, I will show already predefined Google Form. And I will show with what are the different types of settings that are involved in Google Form. First, this is the interface for creating a Google Form. If you want to create a name for this Google Form, just click on here. Okay, this is the header. Both will be same. So whatever you change here, registration from for students. So to create a Google form for the registration form for the students, then you just click on registration form. And after that, we have different settings. Okay. So this we will discuss later. So this is your theme. So whether you want to change the theme of this one. Okay. So how I got this header image by using this one, image upload. So go to here. And you can take the predefined themes, otherwise you can take browse whichever photo. If you want to create a registration form for your college, then go to settings and select the photo that you want to upload. Okay, this is for your themes. And if you want to change the theme of this one, then you can change the theme. Like if you want to change the theme to some other color, and you can change the background color also, everything, okay, by using this theme options. Okay, this is about theme options. And the next one is preview. Settings we will go later. First we will go to this. Whenever you are creating this Google form, just you can give the title over here, and that can be reflected over here. And if you want to create a question, okay, you just click on this one. Okay, if you want to create a question, you can just click on this plus symbol. We can create different types of questions. Okay, I will show what are the different types of questions. Total 11 type of questions will be there. The first one is the short answer type question, okay, which is just a single line of answers we can give. And paragraph, we can give long type of questions, and multiple choice questions, okay. And next, checkbox. Okay, what is the difference between multiple choice and checkbox? We can select only one option at a time in multiple choice, whereas in checkboxes we can select more than one option. And drop down list, file upload, whether we want to drop down list, I will show all these with examples. And file upload, whether you want to upload the file or not. Okay, if I are asking the student to write on a paper, and we will ask the students to upload that by using this file upload. Linear scale, which is used to give some rating kind of thing, whether you want to rate between 1 to 10 scale, then I will go for this linear scale. And multiple choice grid and checkbox grid, all these I will explain, okay, with examples. And whether we want to, we will ask the student to enter the date and time, okay, like date of birth, then I will go for this date. Okay, all these are the different types of questions that are there in Google Form. So first, if you want to create a question, okay, so just click on this question, okay, and you have to give the question. What is the, if I want to create a registration form, so this Google Form is mainly used for two purposes. One is either I can create some application forms or registration forms or administration forms, or one more option is there, that is Google Form I can use for the conducting online quizzes. Okay, we will see that conducting online quizzes and how to set some time limit for the quizzes, everything we will discuss later. In this video I will mainly discuss how to create Google Form. I will show already predefined form, like first name. I created this first name, and whenever you return as first name, then automatically by using this artificial intelligence, it will directly give it a short answer. So the first name, which is a short name, so I will go for this short answer text. And after that, why it is getting answer key? Because I selected it as in the settings, in the quizzes, it is making as a quiz. So I won't do it as quiz. So this is a general Google form, so I won't make it as quiz. Next one, first name, it is a short answer. And what are the settings over here? This is for duplicate. Okay, whether you want to duplicate this question again, then I go for this duplicate. And this is mainly used for deleting the question. And if you make it as required, then everything will be that question is compulsory. So it has to be like it will give you this star mark so that it has to be answered by the student. Okay. So and this is about description. If you want to give some description to this particular question or form option, then I will give this description. And response validation. Okay, whether I want to validate the response. And for each one, we have this one. If I want to create the new question, then click on add question. And this is import questions, which is used to import questions from other Google form. Okay. And this is for add title and description. If you want to add the header and footer kind of thing, then I go for this one. And this is used for creating, adding some images. Okay. All these we will use in the questions. Okay. Whenever you are creating questions, and if you want to ask the question with some image, then I will add an image, and I can add video. And this is section. We can add different sections. Okay. If you want to add different sections within the Google form, then I will go for this add sections. Like one section is used for registration form, and another section is for conducting quiz. After filling up his registration form, then only he will go to the next section. Then I will divide different sections by using the sections tab. Okay. Next, I will add one more question. For adding the new question, just click on this one. Okay. So I will add pin number. Okay. So pin number also I will give short answer only, because in our pin number we will have like a 19001 CM. Okay, like this. So that I will give this pin number with this option. And I can have branch. This is of which type? Dropdown. Okay. So this question is of dropdown type, so that they can select different branches. DAE, DEEE, DC, all these are branches. So this is a branch type of question in which is a type drop down, so that they will select these options from the drop down of list. And next, year of study, which is also of drop down type, so that they can select from this drop down list. And which shift do you belong to? This is of multiple choice type. Okay, either they can select shift 1 or shift 2. So only these two questions. Okay. So for this, actually, whenever you have this drop down or checkbox or multiple choice, if you go to these three dots, this required means whether you want to make it as required field, so that the student has to compulsory fill that particular field. And in the three dots, there is an option called shuffle option order. Okay, this is mainly useful for the quizzes. At the time of quiz creation, I will show that one. And date of birth, whether this is of date type. Okay, we will make it as date type. Okay, just click on this add question, and whenever this question is there, then you will write the question and what is the type of that question, whether it is a short answer, paragraph, or multiple choice, or checkboxes, or drop down, file upload. Short answer is for short answers, and paragraph is for long answers. If they have to write, tell me about yourself, then they have to write this by using paragraph. Multiple choice questions and checkboxes and drop down and file upload. Whether we will ask the student to upload his photo, whether we want to ask the student to upload his resume. Okay, at that time we will use this file upload. And linear scale mainly used for if you want to give rating to that particular thing, then whether you want to give the rating to 1, 2, 3, 4. This is mainly used for the whenever you are creating some surveys, or whenever you are creating some feedback forms, then this linear scale will be used. And multiple choice grid, I will discuss this in the quiz. And checkbox grid, it is mainly used to take the date, like date of birth. Okay. And gender, which is male or female, I am using multiple choice. Okay. So, and category, so which is of drop down. Okay. And after that, languages, this is a checkboxes. Okay. The student can select, he can opt for more than one option, then he will choose this languages now. Okay. Types of questions. Once these questions are created, then this we already discussed how to customize the theme so that I can place this photo and I can change the background color or everything. Okay, that is about theme. And this is preview option, which is mainly used for checking whether everything is entered correctly or not. Okay, so just how the student can see whether when I send this form, how the student can able to see. That is done by using this preview. So just click on preview. So this is the way the student will see why I am getting this email address. I will show in the settings. Next, he will enter the email address and he will give the first name and PIN number. Branch he will select. Okay, this is first name and PIN number. These are shorter and this is a required question. So that's why it is showing as star. Okay, so compulsory you have to fill up this one. And branch he can select from these branches. Okay, drop down list. Okay, so and next one is year of study and which shift he belongs to and date of birth. What is his date of birth so that he will select from this years. Okay, and next gender and what is the category and what are the languages. No, how I am getting this, send me a copy of my responses, everything I will show. Why I am getting this progress bar, page 1 of 1, everything I will show in the settings. Okay, now I will go to the settings. So this is over and this is preview which will show how this Google form will be looking to the student after sending. And now I will go to the settings, which is very important part. Once you go to the settings, here we have three types of categories in the settings. One is general and the next one is presentation and the next one is quizzes. So if you go to the general settings, okay, so whenever you are preparing some feedback forms or online surveys or whenever you are creating some registration forms, then only general and presentation are important. And only for if you are creating quizzes, then we will see this quizzes tab. So in case of general, I make it as collect email addresses. Okay, collect email addresses. That's why it is showing email address directly and at the first. Okay, so if you go to the settings, collect email addresses so that it will collect the email addresses and response recipients or response receives. Okay, that is if respondent requested. So that's why whenever you go here at the ending, you are getting send me a copy of responses. Whether I want to send copy to that particular mail or not. Okay, after filling up this form, whether I want to get a copy of my responses to my mail. So that option can be given by using this response receives. If respondent requested, okay, if I select that one, then I will get that option. Okay, so whether if he requests only, then only he will get that response to his mail. And require sign in, it limit to one response. What it means that I don't want to allow the student to fill up this form multiple times. I want to limit that person or the student to fill up this form only once. So that is where limit to one response. And after that, respondents can edit after submit. Whether I want to make the students to edit this form after submission. And whether they can see summary charts or text responses. All these are the different options in the general. General is mainly whether you can collect the email addresses, whether we can give the chance to send these responses to his mail ID or not, and whether we want to limit this form to be filled up only once, and after he filled up also, whether I want to make the student to edit or not. Okay, all these are options in the general. And the next one is presentation, show progress bar. That's why it is showing like this is the progress bar, page 1 of 1, like this. Okay, next one is shuffle question order, which is mainly used in the quizzes. At the time of quiz creation, I will show this. What is shuffle question order? Show link to submit another response. Whether I can show the student to submit one more response. Okay, next, quizzes. If you want to make this as quiz, then I will enable this, make this as quiz. But now I don't want to make this as quiz. In the next video, I will show how to create quizzes and how to make time limit for the quizzes. So all these settings are over. Now I will have this send. How I will send this form to the student by using this send option. Before that, I will go to the settings. Here we have different settings like make a copy. Whether you want to make a copy of this registration form, whether you want to move it to trash, and whether you want to take the printout, okay, If I click on print out, then printout will come. So like this, the same questions will give printout, so that I can take this printout and I will give offline to the students. And some more options like add collaborators, which is mainly used for whether after creating this form, I will add one more faculty in the add collaborator section, so that I will ask him to check, and he can also modify this form. Okay, that is about add collaborator. And add-ons, which is mainly used for different add-ons are there. I will show in the next video. We have different types of add-ons. Whenever you click on this add-ons, this screen will come. Okay, in which we have number of add-ons are there. Okay, each add-on has some specific purpose. Like it is like a app for this Google Forms. Okay, so next one is preferences. This is not required. So once this everything is created, and after checking this by using this preview, okay, checking with preview whether everything is perfect or not, okay, then I will go to whether if you want to make it as compulsory to answer, then I have to make it as required. Otherwise I will leave it as blank. Okay, these are in this we have this first name, which is compulsory, and pin number is compulsory, and the remaining are optional. Okay, if you want to make it as compulsory, then you have to go to that particular question and you have to select this required. Okay, and once everything, that form is ready, and after preview, then everything is perfect, then I can send this Google form to many other by using this send option. Just click on send, and this I can send by using email. I can write the email ID, okay, for whichever you want to send. I will type those email IDs, and other way is by using link. Okay, and one more thing is by using embedded HTML. This is mainly used for website. If they want to keep this form in the website, then they will use this embedded HTML in their website code. And the best way is used to send this one. Okay, send through link. If it is a big link, then I can shorten by using this one, shorten URL, so that it will be shortened. This will come. You just copy this one and you just share with all the students by using WhatsApp or by using Gmail or by using Google Classroom. Once you share that one, then just click on that one and just click on here, so that registration form will come. Okay, yeah, this is the way to create a Google form. And what are the settings involved in this Google form? Okay, once that Google form is prepared, then how can you send this Google form to the students? Okay, hope this video will be useful to some teachers and faculty members who wants to create Google forms. Thank you all. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel.